What are we up to today?
Hey, Cass. We're going to use a gyratory compactor to compact an asphalt specimen today.
Gyratory? Sounds like it belongs on a spaceship.
No, actually, we're just going to apply a pressure and gyrate the sample during the compaction process. So like I said, we're going to use the gyratory compactor here in the laboratory to compact the asphalt specimen. So essentially it's going to apply a pressure and it's going to spin around at a tilted angle. Not that far. It's a little over 1 degree, and it's intended to simulate the angle between the asphalt roller and the asphalt pavement out in construction.
How much load is applied during the process?
Oh, good question. So according to ASHTO 312, it needs to apply 600 kPa, which is about 87 psi.
Like K-pop?
No. KPA stands for kilopascals, and it's a metric unit of measurement for pressure.
So I saw you were mixing up some of that asphalt a minute ago. Are we going to use that mix?
No, we're going to use mix that I mixed up this morning. Okay, so we put this in the oven, and we age it at the compaction temperature for at least 2 hours.
Aged? It's like you.
No, come on. The other thing that's been in the oven is the gyratory mold and its base plate.
Whoa.
So the base plate and the mold have been in the oven at the compaction temperature for at least 30 minutes. That compaction temperature is a little over 300 degrees Fahrenheit.
I'm glad we have on our PPE.
Oh, me too. One of the first things we're going to do is we're going to put one of these papers in there so that it doesn't stick to the mold.
Brown paper. Cool.
Yeah. Next, I'm going to dump this mix into a funnel. It just makes it easier to put into the mold. So we check the weight.
That's based on the compacted height, right?
It is. This is a design mix, so all that weight was determined at the mixing point, but we're in the right range. Next, we're going to pour the mix into the mold. We're going to do it all in one motion or lift so that we don't get segregation.
Another round paper now?
Not quite yet. We're going to take and round the top of the mix off so that it doesn't all slump to one side. Now we're ready for the round paper. And we're going to take this off to the gyratory compactor.
Oh, which compactor are we going to use?
Well, they're all calibrated to give us the same compaction, and every brand does a pretty good job, but we're going to use this one. And the molds are different, so we need to use the right machine.
What controls are we going to use in this process?
Well, today we're going to compact the number of gyrations, so we're just going to check the number of gyrations.
How do we know how many?
Well, it depends on the specification that comes from the agency. Today we're using 50.
Okay.
This particular one has a top plate, so I've got to put the top plate in motion before we start.
Can I push start?
Of course. So once the ram is up in position, it starts to gyrate.
Wow, that's a cool sound. It sounds like a droid talking.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Well, sounds like it stopped.
It has. After the gyrations are complete, it just stops. So this one, we're going to eject the sample out the top. Some of the other ones have a jack on the side, and we'll push it out from there. So we got to remove this top plate next.
Sounds simple enough.
See that button that says up? Why don't you hold that, but hold on to it.
All right.
Okay, so now that the sample's out, we're going to remove the papers.
Still pretty hot though, right?
It is. So we have to be careful. Good for the PPE. So now that we have it out, we're going to label it and set it somewhere cool before further testing.
So what do we call this chunk of asphalt?
Well, it depends on the region or the lab that you're in. Some places call it a puck, others call it a pill, a briquette, a plug. Some just call it a compacted specimen.
Cool.
So Cass, after all this, what are your takeaways from today's session?
Well, we're going to take the mix out from the oven and then pour the proper amount into a hot mold.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're gonna put a top plate on if needed.
Oh, hold on. What about the papers?
Oh, yeah. Round paper on the top and round paper on the bottom so it doesn't stick.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're gonna put the sample into the gyratory compactor.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna verify the setting and push start.
Yep.
And then after the compaction, we're gonna remove the sample from the mold. Then we're gonna remove the papers,
mm-hmm.
label it,
yep.
and then put it somewhere to cool it before we move on to more testing.
Sounds to me like you've got it. So there's more samples in that oven. What do you say you help me compact some more?
You bet.
All right.